We're going to place these four fractions on this number line. Right now, the number line takes us from 0 to 1, and it's divided into equal parts. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's divided into equal parts. Each equal part is an eighth. So 1/8 would accurately be placed where the first eighth of the number line is, and 2/8 belongs right here. That's pretty straightforward. But I'm going to change the number line a little bit. I'm going to remove some of the partitions so that now the number line is divided into fourths. 1/4, 2/4, 3/4, and then to 1, or 4/4. So now where do these eighths belong? Well, if we change the way that the eighths are represented, we might learn more about them. Here's our 1/8, and here's our 2/8, and here's 1/4. Let's look at that again. 1/8, 2/8, and 1/4. And we can see that 2/8 is twice the size of 1/8, and it's the same size as, well, come on, move over there, as 1/4. So 1/4 and 2/8 are the same, and 1/8 is half of that amount. So let's do some more with this. So the 1/4, we know where that goes. Right there on 1/4. The 2/8, we know where that goes because it's the same as the 1/4. It's another name for the 1/4. And 1/8 is half of the 2/8, and it goes right about there, right in the middle. 3/8, well, that's going to be the same as 1/8 plus 2/8. And let's prove that. Let's just move these up here for a moment and make sure that this all makes sense. So if you take the 1/8 and you add it to the 2/8, check this out. It's going to have the same height as the 3/8. So we're going to put them back on the number line. The 2/8 was here, and the 1/8 was here, and then the 3/8, well, that's the same as 1/8 plus 2/8, and that's why it fits right here. You take the 2/8 and you add one more. That's how we place these fractions on the number line.